are you guys? Anyways, this is my capstone project, and it's by me, of course. My first slide is about... Why is it like that? What's going on? Is to help... This class has helped me with my people skills, that's why I'm in it. And also to help with my past fears of talking to people. There was this one time in high school I actually fainted, so that's another good why, another reason why I should take this class, because I don't want to faint, and also I tend to stutter in front of big groups of people in classrooms when I'm presenting a project, because I would always do it with a group of people instead of by myself. So that's another good reason why I'm in this class, and also to help my knowledge of computers, because sure, I know how to do Word presentation. I didn't know a lot about Excel. I didn't know the resources of college, and I think that's a good reason why I'm in this class, because me and my counselor wanted me to be knowledgeable, to be successful in college while in this class. So those are my reasons why I'm taking this class. My library assignment helped me with my people skills, pretty much. And the library assignment. Anyways, the project helps me to see a reasonable lessons, my valuable lessons in asking to help, since I tend to want to work alone, because I would either be doing the entire project by myself or with a person. So I wouldn't ask for help with the teacher. I wouldn't ask help from the people that I would work with. So the valuable lesson with the library assignment was to ask for help, because I remember asking a few of the classmates for help, like Coral and Woods, and also Tiana. Tiana. I asked for their help, and that helped me, because it was a fear of mine to look dumb or stupid or just not being able to do something on my own. So that is my valuable lesson, to ask for help even if you don't need it, because I always thought that I could do that on my own. My past struggle is that to help me see that I've always worked alone, so I wanted more help. Everything is in order of just like one thing. In the library assignment, I asked for help. That was the number one reason why I picked this project. And also those reasons, because I asked for help. Because, like I said before, with the valuable lessons, the past struggle is that I refused to ask for help, and my grades, my GPA, would struggle. And I would tend to be bullied by students because I would look stupid for not asking for help, because I didn't want to look stupid, but I made myself look like it anyways because I was too afraid. So there is my past struggle. A skill is that asking, actually projecting my voice to ask help, actually raising my hand and speaking out, because I had to break it. And either I would always get stuck with doing everything in the group right away or nothing at all. So that's a good reason why I picked the library assignment and this class, because we did things as a group. We would ask for help. All of us did not get stuck with nothing or everything, and that's why I think the library assignment helps me. And also knowing my resources, like, hey, your next quarter you're going to be taking math and English. Go to the library. This is where it's at. This is the buildings that you can go to ask for help. That's why the library assignment is important to me personally. The SWOT assignment, the valuable lesson in that was for me to reflect on myself, to reflect on my past. I've always gave up too soon or didn't put enough effort into my projects, into myself necessarily, because I would tend to give up if someone said, you did this the wrong way, or my teacher told me that you should have done this instead of that, because I would never ask for help or try hard enough to make it seem perfect or exact, because I would do it my way instead of the teacher's or the exact instructions. Amazing how I passed high school, huh? Joking! A past struggle is that I tend to give up too soon, because my anxiety, depression, all connects and it goes into a cycle. You reject stuff. You don't ask for help. and all goes in over and over. And being bullied in high school, I just tend to not want to do stuff. And instructions, if they're not thorough enough, like in high school, which sometimes they weren't, I wouldn't ask for help because I thought I did everything correctly because they just weren't thorough, or my teacher wasn't thorough enough. But this class, my teacher was thorough, and I would ask for help, and that made me reflect that in college, I need to ask for help. I need to do something different that I wasn't doing in high school. So that past struggle, I think I've broken because I've been asking a lot of questions, a lot of help, and I reflect on myself, reflect on my own personal struggles. A skill is that where I would do work immediately. Like in high school, I would not do work immediately, but now I have. Then times that I would procrastinate, I would not do work on time, and I would tend to just wait to the last second to do stuff. Like yesterday, I forgot that something was due for my self-defense. I had to return paperwork in, but I got it there. But I'm trying my best. In this class, and also Digital 101, I have not procrastinated. I have done my work. There have been times I've gotten confused. That's on me, I will say. But my procrastination's over with. I'm not gonna do that anymore. Because that's what caught me in my bad grade cycle of not wanting to do it, not asking for help. So I've been breaking that struggle of procrastination because there's always procrastinations in your life. Children, for instance, I'm a babysitter actually. I work for free. And donating blood, that's important to me. Reading books, there's a couple books I've been reading, 20 pages a day to help me with my English. And by the way, 3 books, 20 pages. How much pages is that? That's a lot of pages I've been reading. Anyways, I'm pretty proud of myself about that. With that, I have been breaking my cycle of procrastination and also reflecting on what I've been doing right and wrong. And procrastination means that the stuff that you need to do and want to do for me, the wants is that I want to play a video game, but what I need to do is my homework, ask for help for a teacher, email them, do this right now before it's too late or else that's going to be docked. And I'm in college to get a degree, doctorate's degree to be honest. So I need to do work on time and be more thorough with my time. So I guess time management is also on my reflection too, that I need to take more consideration in my time. And eating on a budget. And eating on a budget, a valuable lesson is to save money for me, because when I would have money, I would spend it on junk food. I would also spend it on food I didn't even eat. It would go bad, it would go moldy. So I had to reflect on that. The valuable lesson is that buy foods that you want to eat, because I would buy vegetables that I didn't even know, or fruit that I didn't even know were like, and I wanted to taste it, and I wind up eating it and wasting money on that food. So I should want to taste stuff and try new things, but I should really think about buying stuff before I try it. Think like, would I eat this? Does it smell good? Or how much money is it? Is it wasting money? Will this go bad in my fridge? Reflecting is also another valuable lesson in eating on a budget. Past struggle is that I would waste money on things I didn't need, like candy, for instance. I'm a big gum person. I love gum. That's a struggle, even today, kind of. But I've been working on it. I don't have gum right now, and today. So that was a myth that I was munching on earlier. Anyways, wasting money on candies, treats, cookies, cakes. I used to love sugar a whole bunch. I've been trying to cut down on that because it's not good for me, even though my doctor, by the way, personal information, is that I have low blood sugar, so I could eat as much candy as I wanted and it wouldn't matter. So that's why I would waste my money on candy and sugar, because I just thought it would be healthy no matter what. Turns out that my BMI has gone up, my sugar levels have gone up, and I need to work on that because I want to stay healthy as long as possible. And a skill is, thanks to this class, is that a problem that I've been working on, and also a skill that I've been working on, is to be aware of how much I spend and what I will use in the future of what I eat, and what I should think about. What do I like? What can I do? I like bananas. I like oats. Boom! I can make pancakes out of that. I am also vegan to help out on that, and the reason why because to lower my blood sugar, because I had family members that are addicted to sugar and alcohol, and I'm not even 21 yet, so that ain't a problem yet. But sugar is the main addictive in my family, so I want to cut back on unhealthy food as much as possible. And my mementos is my bracelet right here, commitment, because I want to commit to college. I want to commit to everything. I want to be perfectionist. I want to be perfect at everything. I want to be good at everything. As for help, as this, go to the library, which I've been doing. And also making sure that I use my resources as much as possible. And I've been going onto this website that's been talking about the Great Barrier Reef that's been dying. My degree is in marine biology. And I go on that website every single day to see if something has changed. Is it still dying? Has someone helped it? I need to get my degree. I need to be good at my job. That's why I'm in college, to be good at this job that I want. And so far there's nothing new about that website, but I'm hoping that will change, or I can change that problem myself. And also my ring for high school, because I had to work hard to get this ring. I had to work hard in high school, even with the bullying, the anxiety, the depression. I had to work hard to get my ring. I had to work hard to get those grades that I wanted. So that is why these two things, and also this, are very important to me, and why I want to work hard in college, why I want this so badly, because it's either college or work, and I have to do work later, but I'd rather be smart and also get a good education now than later, because it's harder to learn when you get older, as people have been telling me. So, the end.
All right. Good job. Questions, comments, and talk. Megan.
Yes.
I forget on the top of my head, what is a vegan?
A vegan is a person who only eats vegetables and fruit and grains, because no meat, no cheese. Plus, I actually have family members that are allergic to milk and dairy, so that's just why, another good reason why. But my mom ain't giving up bacon worth anything, so the rest of my family is normal. They eat bacon, they eat normal hamburgers, and I'm the only one who eats a whole bunch of vegetables and fruit every single day. They think I'm crazy, but I'm not, just overly healthy. So that's me, the healthy person in my family that doesn't eat ice cream or cake, because I can make it on my own, because they buy it processed. So healthy.
Other questions, comments, or thoughts?
Yes.
You had mentioned one of the skills you want to get better in is computers over the course of this class. So what has improved? What programs or things like that have you been working on?
For Digital 101, we had the screenshot, everything that we've done, and the PowerPoint, and also Excel were one of my two things I wanted to work on the most, because I had no idea what I could do. And for the capstone project, I had no idea that I could put pictures in there, because my friends would always do that for me. They would either do the presentation part for me, the project, so I had to do this on my own, because everything in high school groups, and yet I would do with nothing when it came down to computers. That's why I wanted to work on it. So the pictures I had to work with family and friends on, so I did that on my own, all by myself. Pretty proud of myself. Plus, I had to pick out the design by myself, and also I had to actually look up YouTube videos. And the Excel, he actually helped me on learning that I could actually do like financial stuff on there. I could do graph bars on there. I could do my schedule on there, or a calendar. So that's what I've been working on mainly, because I think that would be good for my classes, because I'm taking two math classes and also one CPR class this next quarter, summer quarter. So yeah.
Alright, more questions, comments,
or
thoughts?
Yes.
There is some relatable things that I got with you. Struggles in school, bad grades. Like, in high school, only near the end, in the finals, did I truly put all my power into studying the entire week just for the finals. When I was in elementary school, around 3rd or 4th grade, because when I was younger, I was 10 times more hyper, and I would always sleep in class, get in conflicts with classmates, even my my sixth grade teacher didn't really like me. Mm-hmm. So when everyone graduated and was crying because we're leaving elementary school, I was one of the ones left out.
Yeah, for me, when it came down to history class with documentaries, I would pass out for 5 minutes because I'm just like, the monotone voice was just so boring and it made me sweep, and they would leave the classroom cold, and I sleep better in the cold. So I get you on that part, but studying wasn't necessarily a big problem necessary because I loved studying. When it came down to me putting on my headphones, I would lock my door and say, don't come in, I'm studying, leave me alone, be quiet out there. Mm-hmm. So studying wasn't a big issue, but when it came down to tests, boom, my disability would come in because my disability is a memory loss, basically. The memory loss is that my anxiety, depression mix in these two chemical compounds, and they make a memory loss formula, basically, where I would forget everything. It doesn't matter if I spent 2 weeks studying, everything gone. It doesn't matter. Like, I could remember two or three things. The dorsal fin in marine biology class. There's a dorsal fin. There's a caudal fin. What is that fin called? What is that organ? What's the extra eyelid for? I forgot. What's going on? I studied. So because of that, I've had to work extra hard on everything, and I've had to have accommodations for it. But I've tried not to use those accommodations because, to me, that's cheating. And I hated that. So I had to work extra hard, and I wouldn't ask for help, so I would have to go back to my notes. I would put sticky notes on my mirror and say, you know what, it's just a test. Why am I so scared of it? It's like a monster that's going to chew me up if I don't get it right, basically. That's what I get telling myself in this head. That's going to ruin my life. But I graduated. I made it. I'm in college. There's no reason to be scared at all. It's just paper or a computer with questions and bubbles on it now. There is no reason why, but I still get nervous, so I just don't understand why it's still a problem, but I'm trying to break it down with my struggles.
Your result is very admirable.
So Megan, one thing that I really, 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 give you three really enjoyed about your presentation is you went about it in a different way. Where everyone else kind of, you know, they pick the one they want to talk about, and then they kind of talk about three different struggles, you actually took the assignment and then you applied the three different topics to it. So you did the valuable lesson, you did the past struggle, and then you did the skills game. I really like that because it shows that analytical side, that self-awareness from you to say, hey, this is what it was, this is where I'm at right now, this is how I'm going to try to gain the skill, and this is how this skill is going to help me in the future. So I think that's a really powerful attribute that you have in yourself, and as you go forward, that's what's going to carry you through to your success.
Thank you, and also the reason why I did that is because everything to me is a cycle that I have to work on stuff. My anxiety, my past is my issue, and I don't tend to learn my past very well because it keeps recycling. It's like you rewind and you reread it, you rewind everything. And that's why I've connected all the dots, basically. And also, I highlighted the words there to make it more organized and make me more self-aware of my problems, even when I was doing this project.
Right. Applause.
Yes.
Good job. I really like it.